everyone. Welcome. Thank you so much for joining me here today for our slow stretch flow today. We aren't going to be moving anything one breath per movement. Everything is going to be a couple of breaths, sinking into all of the postures, just getting a nice full body opening and releasing today. So we won't need any props. All we need is a mat, our practice space, and if you would like a water or a pillow, that's welcome as well. When you are ready and set up, please join me standing right now. We're gonna start the class up on our feet and then we'll get down on the ground. So standing at the top of your mat. Once you're here, just finding a soft bend in the knees, the hands rest by the sides, palms face forwards. Gently tuck the chin and then feel the weight of the feet and the 10 toes, maybe shifting forwards and backwards, side to side. Just feeling all edges of the feet on the floor. And then come into that centered, balanced position. And taking three deep breaths here. If you'd like to invite in your Ujjayi breath now, you may. One more round of breath here. You're welcome to keep your eyes closed for the remainder of class or bring them gently to an open. With an inhale, reaching the arms overhead. Exhale, hands through heart center. Draw that belly button in just a bit here. Inhale, reach the arms overhead. Bring the palms together. And as you exhale, fold over to the right side. Opening that armpit up to the ceiling. Reaching through the fingertips. Maybe turn the gaze up towards the ceiling. Or leave it forwards. Gentle tuck through the chin still. Each exhale, pushing that left hip away from you. One more breath out here. And then dropping right ear to right shoulder, take right hand to left ear. Left hand reaches away from you, palms facing forward, spread through the fingertips. Soften right shoulder away from that right ear. Breathing space into the left side of the neck. Just a gentle pressure of right hand to left side of the head. Deep breaths here. And then take the palm, face it down towards the ground, fingers still spreading away from you. Next exhale, palm will face the back of the mat, thumb face down. Keep spreading through those fingers. Keep those deep breaths rolling. One more inhale here. As you exhale, release both hands down towards the sides. The chin rolls down to the chest. Inhale, roll the neck up long. Exhale, roll the neck back down, chin to chest. Breath in, roll the neck, reach the hands overhead. Palms come together at the top. Exhale, reach up and over to the left side. Open those right ribs, right armpit up to the ceiling, chin tucked. Eventually, gaze will follow up to the ceiling as well, if comfortable in your body. Press that right hip away from you. Up and over through the fingertips. soft knees, soft core connection. One more exhale here. And then inhaling, reach those right fingertips over to right side. Left ear to left shoulder, find weight of left hand onto the right side of the head, right ear. With your next exhale, take the palm, face it down towards the ground. Keep spreading through those fingertips. Next exhale, palm faces the back of the mat, thumb downwards. Reach through that pinky. Big breath in here. As you exhale, release hands to the side, roll the chin down to the chest. Inhale. One vertebra at a time, roll the neck to straight. Exhale, roll it back down. Inhale, roll the neck up. As you exhale, roll the neck down and then continue round through the shoulders. Roll one vertebra at a time with soft knees all the way down to the ground. Let those shoulders hang. Bend the knees. Rest the belly on the thighs. You're welcome to just keep the hands weighted on the earth, maybe cross the arms, allowing for the shoulders and the head to hang, maybe sway or rock the head yes and no. One more exhale here. And then find the hands on the floor in front of the feet as you begin to sit down onto the hips, crossing the legs in front of you. Whichever leg naturally falls in front first is just fine. Point through those toes. Sit up tall through the belly button and the spine. Then with an exhale, just walk the hands in front of you as you begin to fold towards the floor. Maybe the forearms come down, maybe the forehead can come down, or just rest wherever you find your depth in this fold. Both hips equally weighted on the ground. You can push into the hands to push those hips further back. Deep breaths into the hip space here. Slow the breath down even more. Send the mental awareness to where you feel this. Stay in these postures. Sometimes it's even more difficult to stay aware of the body and stay present in these slower classes. So just work towards coming back to the breath or coming back to the physical sensations whenever you feel the mind wander. One more exhale to this side. And then as you inhale, walk yourself back up to the seat, reach the arms overhead. And exhale, we'll take left hand to right knee, right hand behind you for a twist. Chin to tuck through the chin. No need to exert yourself here, just finding a soft spinal twist. Shoulders down away from the ears. A slight activation through the belly button. Maybe the gaze, the chin goes towards the back shoulder. Breath out here. As you inhale, rotate forwards. Take that front leg, the front cross of the leg, squeeze the knee into the chest, and then lengthen it down on the ground, opposite bottom of the foot into the thigh to create a four through the legs. Square the shoulders towards the long ankle, sit up tall, and then exhale, soft fold. We haven't found any heat in the body for these stretches today, unless you might have done something before this. So these are soft, subtle stretches. There's no need to find your deepest posture unless your body is ready for that. So just feel into the muscle, breathe into the muscle, and find the comfortable depth for you. As you settle in, maybe each exhale getting deeper, but listening to your body with these early stretches. Take the hands, walk them outside of this long leg. As far to the side and then forward as you can, keeping that opposite hip heavy on the earth. Pressing that bent knee to the ground away from you. Your next exhale draws the torso back to center. And then inhale, roll the spine up into your seat, switching out the cross of the legs now. Finding probably that awkward cross, point through the toes. The tops of the feet kind of come to the floor, sit up tall. Find that equal weight on the earth through the hips. And then begin to fold yourself forwards, arms walking out in front of you. Maybe forearms or the forehead find the floor, and if not, that's just fine today. Push into those palms to push the hips behind you. One more breath out here. And inhale, rolling yourself back up into the seat. Take the arms overhead with you. And exhale, right hand to left knee. Left hand draws back behind you for your twist. Long lower back. Reach out the top of the head, the chin slightly tucked. And then from that space, shoulders draw down. So you find your gentle twist. Finding depth on the breath out, maybe your gaze and your chin rotate towards that back shoulder if comfortable in the neck. Gentle tug on the belly button. One more exhale here. And inhale, unwind back to center. Take that front leg in your cross long. Opposite bottom of the foot into the thigh, sit up tall. Square the shoulders off towards the long ankle. And breath out, draw yourself down to this long leg. Your hands can act as leverage on the calf, the shin, or the foot. Bent knee pressing away from you towards the earth. Both hips heavy. Breathe length into the hamstring, into the lower spine. Take the hands outside of the long leg. And walk them as far to the side and away from you as you can while still keeping that bent leg, hip heavy, connected to the ground. Breathing into the side back. One more breath out here. One more full cycle of breath here. With your next exhale, bringing the torso back over the leg, center line. And then inhaling, rolling yourself back up to your seat. We're going to now take the bottoms of both feet together, knees wide. Find the soft sides underneath the hips. Once we're here, take the hands, clasp them behind you, and take the knuckles to the floor. Once you have this connection of the knuckles, wrap the shoulders back, wrap the elbows back towards each other, and then inhale, lift the chest, lift through the chin, press the heart open and upwards. As you keep that belly button gently connect, push the bottoms of the feet together. Big breaths into the front side. Maybe you drop the head all the way behind you, or just keep that chin slightly lifted if that's not comfortable in your body. Open up, exhales are welcome here. And one more big breath in, full release. And inhale, roll the neck up, release the hands, reach them in front of you to the shins. As you exhale, beginning to fold forwards. The farther the feet are away from you, the more you're going to stretch the IT band. The closer the feet towards the body, the more groin. So you decide where you'd like the stretch to go and then fold into it. You can use the hands or the elbows on the knees as assist to maybe push them wider. Just taking each breath deeper into this posture, whether that just means a deeper breath or actually folding closer to the floor. Breathing weight through the hips and the knees. Length into the spine, softness into the shoulders and the face.
more exhale here. Inhale, bringing yourself up to a seat. And slowly rolling one vertebra at a time all the way down onto your back. Keeping the bottoms of the feet together here. Hands rest by the sides face up. Press those feet into each other as you connect the lower back down onto the earth. Belly pushes down, back pushes down. Feet active as those knees fall wide. Big breaths into the pelvis. You can stay active here if you would like, or with your next exhale, allow the feet to fall open as those knees become closer to the earth. Pelvis really lets go here. Deep breaths. That lower back might start to peel off the earth as you find that softness. To the outsides of the thighs as an assist. Inhale, bring the knees together up towards the ceiling. Bottoms of the feet down on the floor. Scoop that pelvis under, just re-lengthen lower back. And then we're going to take left arm across the chest. Right hand comes to left tricep. Keep the elbow long. Reach out through the fingertips. And just squeeze, press this left arm into the chest with right hand. Two breaths into the shoulder. Keeping this left arm reaching long, take left leg long on the ground. Bring right knee towards chest. Inhale, find a little bit of core connection. Just take your hips slightly over to the right side. And then as you exhale, right knee twists over towards left side. The foot can touch down on the floor. Just reaching hands and knee in opposite directions. Bit active here. Pull the knee away from the body. Pull the fingertips away from the body. With your next breath in, open the arms wide to a T on the earth. That right shoulder connected. Maybe you can deepen into this twist from there. Breathing up and down the spine. Find a breath out. Inhaling, come back to center on your mat. Bring both knees into the chest for a big squeeze. And then lower the feet back down to the floor, knees bent up to the ceiling. This time, right arm is going to cross over the chest. Try to keep that right shoulder searching for the floor. Left hand comes to back of right tricep. Press the arm into the body. Length through the elbow. Length through the fingers. Almost like your right shoulder is pulling to the right, your right fingertips are pulling over to the left. From here, take the right leg, bring it long on the mat, left knee pulls into the chest. And then with an exhale, hips come slightly to the left, draw that left knee over to right side earth. Knee and fingertips reaching in opposite directions. One more exhale here. Then with an inhale, open the arms wide to a T. Take yourself further into this twist as the left shoulder attempts to stay connected to the earth. Full round of breath. On that inhale, drawing back to center, knees will come into chest for a big squeeze. And then taking a happy baby. So knees out towards the armpits. You can grab onto the shins, the ankles, or the bottoms of the feet. As you press those lower vertebrae to the earth, and see if you can keep those shoulder blades connected to the ground. Push hands into feet, feet push back. Just as slow and smooth a breath here as you took in our first few postures. Noting that if there's ever a posture you're looking to rush out of, means you probably should stay for even a few extra breaths. On your next exhale, bring the knees back into the chest and then lower the feet to the floor, knees still bent up to the ceiling. Arms will rest by the sides, palms face down. Tuck those shoulder blades underneath you. Keep that tailbone slightly tucked so the belly draws down to the ground. And then with an inhale, push into the forearms, lift through the chest, bring the top of the head to the earth. Finding a fish pose through the upper body. Really round those shoulders underneath you. Press into the palms. Press that thoracic spine, the spine between the shoulder blades, up towards the ceiling. Open mouth exhales are always welcome in these. One last big breath in. As you exhale, slowly release the spine down to the ground. Shoulder blades still slightly underneath you. Palms face upwards, and when you're ready, lengthen those legs long. And let the knees fall wide, feet fall open. Into your final resting pose, Shavasana, today. allowing the body to settle and to soak up all of the benefits of everything we just did together. Staying present with this physical body for a few more moments. You can choose to surrender here for as long as you see fit. Maybe even entering into a meditation here. Otherwise, this is where I will leave you for today. I hope you enjoyed that slow stretch flow, and I will see you again soon. Thank you.